Oh yeah, oh boy, this shit banging.
Hey, all right, daggum. It's 9 o'clock. It's Wednesday. I'm late to work, but I know I had to holler at them, let them know what's happening. I got a meeting at 9:30, and let me tell you what's happening. Woke up this morning, cardio didn't get done. Had a lot of shit on my mind. Right before I went to sleep last night, I got some. It was bad news, but it's all right now. But this shit just really messed up my vibe, and I didn't really get good sleep. So after all that shit happened, make sure I just pulled out in front of somebody while they turn it. Okay. So after all that shit happened, like, I was just waking up off and on throughout the night, checking my phone, making sure that the shit got resolved, which it did. But my baby kept waking up and sort of fussing, kicking, trying to get comfortable in the bed, kicked me in the eyeball. I mean, heel to the eyeball. Man, that shit hurt. I've been in some fights. And actually, the fights were only when I was in high school. I've only been in one fist fight, and it was basically a one hitter quitter, basically. So I'm gonna be brutally honest with you on that. I would have rather have lost that fight versus rather than win it, because I got in so much trouble for it. You know what I'm saying? Because the kid that I beat up was able to play the victim, and I had to go to court, and it was a lot. And it's just like, why I have to go through all this shit? You know what I'm saying? But that's another story. Anyway, yeah, kick me in the eye. That shit hurt, and I just stayed sleeping with her. I mean, she woke up basically almost every hour after 3. She woke up at 3. No, she woke up at 12. She woke up at 3. She woke up at 4. She woke up at 5. And then stayed asleep. I had to wake up at 7. got her dressed. So, got Rebecca to school. Came to the vault. And after all that leg shit I did yesterday, came in here and did squats. And not necessarily have all the time. The program called for a 3x8, and I didn't feel like I was gonna do a 3x8, so I did a 4x5. and did a heavy single at 445. Everything felt great, even with my legs pumped from yesterday. No lower back issues, no knee issues. All that's great. I'm blessed for that. And now, headed to work with the good lower pump. Body is still looking all right. And I'm gonna go home and take some creatine, which I have deduced that creatine is making me shit a lot, because now that I started picking that back up, I have been pissing out my asshole. Now, it's not hurting my stomach, but it's just something that has to be done. And a good thing to say that that's helping me lose weight. I haven't weighed myself in a minute, but with all that going out, I'm assuming that that is giving me a cut that is showing some definition in other areas, six pack, and my kidney areas are slimming down. But just having to deal with taking shits like that is not comfortable. Nobody likes to have to do that, especially when you gotta clean up your daggum toilet after you didn't finish. But vanity, greed, you know what I'm saying? This is what I want, and I'm making it happen. All that to say, avoid the felony, and I'm gonna get back with you later. Yeah.
Hey, yeah, well, 5:04 in the morning, I'm about to hit bench press up. It's Thursday, and I'm still mad that they done killed Young Dolph. Damn. And I'm late, and I'm real late hearing about Sean Roden. So I don't really want to talk right now, so probably a little later. So I'm gonna get back with you while I hit these weights. Yep.
Hey, all right, damn it, man, I'm gonna tell you, woke up late start, late everything, got the girl at school barely, don't even think about asking me if I did cardio, because the answer is no. So got to the vault late, want to get these deadlifts in, but I'm thinking, I'm thinking. And let me tell you, last night when I went to sleep, I'm thinking to myself, man, I might go for another 605, maybe even a 610. I was feeling that good. Woke up this morning like, nah. Woke up this morning stiff. Woke up this morning just not feeling it. You know what I'm saying? So, got up in here. And first thing I saw was that someone was already using the deadlift bar. And I was like, ooh, that's not a good look for trying to hit some 600s. But I saw the power bar was available. Now, the power bar is a different animal because it's stiff. It does not flex. It does not bend. It does not have whip. As a deadlift bar does have that whip, so when you jerk it off the ground, you get some momentum, you get some inertia off of it, it helps you get that thing up in the air. And I think it's a little, the deadlift bar is thinner in the width, or the diameter, I mean, where I think the power bar is a little thicker. The deadlift bar, the Texas deadlift bar has a lot more knurling than the Texas Power Bar does. Because when I did 555, which I did a heavy jump. I went from 445 to 555. It's pretty. That's just a testament of God giving me the power. All glory goes to Him. That second rep, I was saying to myself, I ain't got a good hold of it. And then of course that third rep slipped out of my hand. Didn't get it. And I wasn't mad because I knew it was a grip thing. And I didn't necessarily know how bad, or I won't say how bad, but just how different the grip and the knurling is on the bar until I got to that point of 555 and realized I can't hold it. And then that's when you see Iron Vault has liquid chalk. There's chalk available. So the good thing is that the gym, which I always try to tell folks, everything is in there for you to get better. You know what I'm saying? That's the blessing of a gym, that everything in there is for you. No matter what it is, no matter what you see, it's in there specifically for you to use, for you to make yourself better. So the program called for a heavy single at 90%, which was 553, made it 555. And then the working sets was a 3x6 at between 70 and 75%. I did it at 445 because I just didn't feel like doing the math and making 460. And because 460 would have been 75%. And I think 430 is 70% of my one rep max. So I left it at 445, did the 3x6. And I can't remember what the first set felt great, but the second and third set felt really great. And I can really contest the difference between using liquid chalk, which I haven't used chalk in a long time. So using the chalk versus just my bare grip, bare dry ass hands, played a huge difference, benefited me a lot. And of course, maybe in the future, if I'm going for a heavy, if I'm trying to go for 615 or an actual one rep max of the six, you know, anything over 615, I'll probably try and use some chalk, because I don't want anything to be an excuse for why I didn't get it. But for right now, I feel good. My back's all right. You know what I'm saying? It's not 100%. I kind of feel a little bit, but that's just what the game is about. But I'm going to get back in the house and get ready I'm late for work, but they already know I'm here. But Saturday, bench. Sunday, I want to try and wake up super early to do squats, but since that's the AK match day, I don't know, but we'll figure it out. I'll figure it out. But I want to start getting some things prepared. Oh, I'm supposed to get the rest of my parts for my drone, so hopefully my homie Nate can fix my drone, my mini, and I can have both drones in the air for the AK match. I really hope that's gonna work. I hope it comes early enough for Nate to pick it up, repair the drone, see if it works, and then bring it back to me today. That's a hard ask, that's a big if, but you know what I'm saying? If you put it in the air, it can't do anything but come down. So hopefully that happens. But I'm gonna get back with you. Avoid the felony. Yeah.